Okay, Marco, as you know, you've got 15 minutes to present. After your presentation, you'll have a seat and you'll receive questions from the Commission. There's pen and paper there, so you can make notes on the questions. Okay. You may start now.
So, good evening, everybody. Thanks, Commission. Today, I will present my research investigation that is socially constructed perceptions of the relationship between seating arrangement and students' engagement. This is a study that was carried out in a sixth grade in Santa Clara School. So, to introduce you, first I will define the two concepts that are dealt in this research, that is engagement and seating arrangement. First, the theoretical, this says, according to Newman, 1992, engagement is defined as active involvement and is referred as an antonym to apathy, lack of interest, and superficial participation. As for seating arrangement, according to Los Angeles County Office of Education in 2000, how students should sit if interactions are sought is a point that needs to be addressed when talking about seating arrangement. So, as for the empirical, Michelini, Pasalama, and Cusimano in 1976 state that research has shown the relationship between the person's position in a class and his or her participation during a group discussion. So here in the empirical, we see that both topics are related and mixed. As for the political, I focus here because on the Basel Curriculares in 2012, there in the English section for sixth grade, retrieved from Ineduc, give detailed explanations and directions toward the focus of teaching English as a second language, but they do not address seating arrangement or engagement. So then we move to the social. PLB 2012 states that students in a traditional row seating arrangement, that are sitting in front of the class, are the ones who participate more and are more attentive to the ones who are at the back of the class. So, statement of the research problem. Situated experiences. What led me to identify this problem in the classroom? So at the beginning of the internship, I was able to observe sixth grade in Santo Tomas School that was composed by 36 students sitting in a normal seating arrangement. That is three rows composed by two desks put together and 12 students per row. As long as the classes were dictated by this teacher, I was able to recognize some differences between groups, that the groups that they were sitting at the front of the classroom were more attentive and more engaged to the lesson given by the teacher than those at the back and at the middle. So, what led me to identify the risk problem? What is the relationship between seating arrangement and engagement in the classroom? That leads us to the deficiency in evidence. As I stated before, in the political reference, Basel Curriculares does not address seating arrangement nor engagement. So this is a clear deficiency in evidence because we don't have guidelines to address this in the Chilean curriculum. So that leads me to the research question. What are the socially constructed perceptions of the relationship between seating arrangement and students' engagement in a sixth grade EFL classroom? So then we move on to the objectives. The objective is to identify what are the perceptions of sixth grade EFL students on the relationship between seating arrangement and students' engagement. So that gives me three assumptions that are related with a theoretical background. That is expected to find the students' perception and how their engagement is related to the seating arrangement. It is expected to find relationship between some special locations be preferred or not by some students due to the disadvantages or advantages that they offer. And it is expected to find how certain seating arrangement provides or not certain advantages over others. And it is expected that students deal with topics who are closely related to engagement, such as motivation, intrinsic and extrinsic. I didn't deal with iterative nor instrumental because of the context that is sixth grade. Methodology, the paradigm. This is interpretive paradigm because it's basically observing, retrieving information from what is observed and what are other materials that are going to be discussed later. Stated by Furusun in 2012, the interpretative paradigm is widely different from positivist studies since interpretive use open-ended questions and are entirely focused on interpretations derived from qualitative data taken from a small group with the aim of exploring meanings on the context of the investigated participants. So, as I previously said, this is related with observing and interpreting what is observed and retrieved from the data collection materials. The approach is a qualitative approach. According to Creswell, exploration and detailed understanding of the problem with minor use of theory, collection of written evidence retrieved from a small group to finally analyze the data and finding a meaning to later writing later writing emerging structures and evaluative criteria. Also including the research subject or reflections. So what is the procedure that I follow? First I observe and I retrieve field notes. Then I conducted an interview with a teacher and I did questionnaires. I selected 9 students to conduct these questionnaires, since according to the approach it's a small group to finally emerge to analyze and interpret their perceptions. So, subjects and key informants. As I already said, this is it's a 6th grade composed by 36 students. The observations were carried out and every Wednesday from 8 to 9:30. There was mainly only observation because I wasn't able to conduct classes or intervene in how the lessons were taught. So this is why I also chose an interpretive paradigm. Classes were developed in English and Spanish, and the teacher also recurred to the native language when it was necessary because students didn't understand. And 9 students out of the 36 were selected. Also, I have some tutor-teacher insights about the classroom. So this is how was the classroom supposed to be, how was the classroom arrangement presented when I arrived. So the teacher was sitting here, and there were the 36 desks with the students, and I selected 9 of them because of the spatial position they had in the classroom, so I could cover the most spatial positions available. So instruments, as I already said before, field notes were carried out, therefore open coding and interviews. The interview was with the teacher. But since the objective here is to focus on the perception of the students, the interview was to present a perspective from their teacher, and not to triangulate their results. And the questionnaires were used with open coding also as the field notes. And to address trustworthiness, credibility, dependability, and confirmability, the researcher, me, I stuck with since I retrieved information from them, I tried to stay as objective as possible, and not to be biased. And not to influence the students' answers in the questionnaire. The questionnaire was composed by 4 questions that were mainly focused on how the students felt in their sitting, in the positions in the classroom. Transferability, according to Creswell, is defined as being as descriptive as possible in the context. But he states that there are no 2 contexts that are exactly the same. findings, analyzing the analysis of data. From the field notes, open coding were disclosed, and emerging categories such as engagement, motivation, and season arrangement were found. Then the questionnaires address the same categories, and then the question was the research question was I could answer the research question saying that there is a relationship between the season arrangement and the engagement the student had. They showed that they showed a clear inclination towards sitting at the front because they felt that they would be more attentive at the classes. Limitations. Number of participants. Since I selected 99 participants, the study was from out of 36, the study could be as not as representative as it should be. And the age of the participants, since in talking about engagement and senior arrangement may be confusing for them. Contributions for the field of education. In this research, we can see that as taking a relationship with the political background, we can see that none of these, in the Chilean context, have addressed engagement and senior arrangement from the point of view of the students. And future directions for the research would be a good idea to link this with motivational research. Metacognitive analysis. Conceptualization of the teacher-researcher role. As the internship was developing, I focused on the fact that students were left behind in topics such as how you feel in the classroom and the class that is provided to you. And this is strictly related to what's happening in the previous internship, where I didn't focus on the student perception, but on theory and what is discussed in books. Strengths, weaknesses, and challenges. According to the Massey University, in my metacognitive analysis, one of my weaknesses was the objectivity in the writing style of the research. Since it's paramount to achieve objectivity in every research, stated by my Massey University, this would be a weakness in my metacognitive analysis. A strength would be that effective classroom management style. This deals with a voice volume, with the ability to connect with students in a way that is not intrusive for them, according to Sherry 2003. And this is the reference that I use for the presentation.
Thank you very much.